So I wrote a song many years ago with my friend Kenny Loggins, who I love. He's an amazing singer-songwriter. We wrote a lot of songs together. This one is a song called Forever, which you may not be familiar with here, but the song was a huge hit in the Philippines. You know why? Where are my Filipino people? I'd have no audience without you guys. I love the Philippines. So we had this big hit over there, and I didn't know who or why or what. Then I found out who the artist was that had this big hit. Then I found out that he was an amazingly famous artist in the Philippines and in Southeast Asia. And when we went there a couple of months ago to play, he guested on our show, and the place went crazy every time he came out. And he's just a wonderful human being. He's here, his family's here, his son is here, he lives in Vegas, this is his son, and he's just an amazing guy. You know who I'm talking about, you Filipino people? Martin Nemero! Hey, buddy.
David!
How are you, man?
Hello, everybody! We're all the Filipinos. We're gonna eat well tonight.
Yes.
You know, this is a dream of mine. I just want you to know.
Oh,
full disclosure, it's been my dream since I started singing 41 years ago, just to meet this gentleman. So I guess I can say that it took me 41 years to be a foster child. It's true, but I'm so happy to be here.
Oh, thank you so much. We love having you, and your son Santino's here.
Yes,
and family here, and your brothers, sisters, sons,
everyone,
brother-in-laws. Yeah, like
even kids I didn't know I had. They're all here. Yeah, what happens in Vegas?
Yes, right. You want to get this shot? This song,
can we, please?
Absolutely.
Okay. This song, ladies and gentlemen, David Foster. Martin. So look, I know you were only supposed to come up with one song, because I'm not paying you. You don't work for free. So
I work for free.
One song, I said, you know, just one song. But I wanted to have a little fun with you, because I saw you do it in the Philippines.
This is one of your show.
Like, it's, you know I don't sing. We've already established that. But maybe we could run through just a few bars of a few of the songs that I wrote.
That you wrote,
and
yes.
Just have fun with it. Like, do you remember this song that I wrote that goes with my friend Boss Kex? Love. Look what you've done to me. Never thought I'd fall in love so easily. Oh, love. You lied to me, leaving me to feel this way. Very good. You know, I thought of another one. Did you ever hear of a song? I can't play this on the piano because we wrote it on guitar, but it's it goes. No, she's a beauty. Oh, you know, it's
my favorite.
No, it's not. It's a group called The Tubes. You've never heard of them. Anyway, forget that. How about this song? A song I did for Chicago called Hard Habit to Break.
Yes!
Now be without you. It's long again, and it's too hard to learn the song they hate. This is unrehearsed.
You wrote it for them.
How about this? Make up different lyrics to songs.
You were not supposed
now,
to
at the risk of, again, ruining my songs, how about if I pick, this is a song I wrote for Earth, Wind, and Fire. Change the lyrics on the spot. You ready? The song is called After the Love is Gone. Okay. You want to think for a minute?
It's a melody.
And oh, after the love.
Okay.
You ready? Okay. Totally blind. You ready? A little high, isn't it? Anyway, here we go. And oh, after the love. Let's pick a song. This is a song. Do you know this? My very first hit, which was actually, I hate to say it, but it was 50 years ago this month.
50 years?
50 years ago. Was a song called Wildflower.
Oh, I know.
Wildflower. Yeah, so how about, you want to do a little thing? I saw you do this with a couple of girls.
You're not supposed
or
to know that. David, when I write a song in my...
You didn't write that song.
No, I didn't. But I chose the lyrics for, you know, for chicks before.
Go ahead.
And it, because he is David...
Go ahead,
Foster.
Ruin another one of my songs. Go
David ahead. Foster, David Imposter. Icon, I cannot. So you're gonna give me a little Wildflower. You want me to change the words?
Yeah, I mean, it's like,
yeah, okay. You know the song, right?
Let her cry for she's.
But you know, I need an inspiration. I'm not David Foster. I'm David Imposter. I need inspiration. Is there a married couple in the audience? You, sir. What is your name?
That's Tom, right? I recognize you. Tom, is that your wife? Are you sure? You were... Yes, what is Tom and?
How do you know a guy named Tom?
I don't know. Was I being, you know, racist or something? Tom, no, we've met before, yes, in the neighborhood. And then I've never met your wife, or have I met your wife? Tom and Jerry? No, Tom and... Laura. Tom and Laura. How long have you been together? How long have you been married? He's looking at you. You saw that? More than seven, obviously. 13 years married. Where did you meet? Make up your mind, which was? Beverly Hills. Nothing sexy about Beverly Hills.
No, nothing sexy, sir.
Nothing. Tom and Laura met in Beverly Hills. And what do you think? Laura, what's the most beautiful thing about Tom? Why do you love him? His heart. His heart.
Now we're getting somewhere.
Not very sexy, but heart. Beverly Hills, Tom, and Laura. Here we go.
Really? You're going to do it?
Do it right now, because we're...
Yeah, she's face.
All right, go ahead.
She's ready. Did Laura and Tom. She's faced the hardest times you could imagine. Many times her eyes fought back the tears.
So far you haven't changed one word.
And when Tom noticed she was laughing, she began to see the future in every loving touch. And then Tom would do Laura a little bit too much. So let her cry. He's not good looking. Let her dream of a man. Let the rain fall down in Beverly Hills. She's in love with his heart, cause that's all Tom has.
Wanna go again?
Let him cry. And then a dream. Tom is the guy. Let the rain fall down. Wait for a child. They will gather here tonight. Mark my words. For the devil will talk to.
You should mention that, because Norman and I go to the audience and I just get random people to sing, but we don't have all night, and there's a couple of people I do want to go to, and my buddy Mark McGrath, the lead singer from Sugar Ray, is here tonight. Mark,
I just want to fly. Come on, man, I'm picking you out of the audience. Just a few bars, buddy. Just a few. Mark McGrath, Sugar Ray.
I guess for this one, you get Mark McGrath, right? How y'all feel, man? Are you all right? David, do we have a minute?
Yeah, sure.
Before we begin, a little showbiz here. I want to say what a joy it is, David. Thank you so much. He's such a legend, this dude. He's so talented. He shaped our lives with his music. And I want to give a huge shout out to his band back here, man. These guys.
Aren't they great?
Unbelievable.
Bo Cooper on keyboards. Johnny Friday on drums from Las Vegas. Keith Nelson from Las Vegas on bass.
Killer band. Yeah. Beyond all this talent and all that, I met him about 25 years ago. He's one of the nicest guys I've ever met in my life. Yes, I hate him. He's charismatic, talent, and good looking at 85 years old. But it's just everything you want to be in an idol, you know? That is Mr. David Foster.
Yeah. Thanks, buddy.
Now, he still won't write a song with me, but that's okay. Because I got my own number one song, and it goes a little something like
that. Oh, yeah.
Windows had done, I loved you. Sing along, y'all. And everywhere I go, people stop and they say, 25 years old, my mother got passed so. Let me hear ya. I just wanna fly. Put your arms around me, baby. Put your arms around me, baby. We only had 6 months rehearsal, you guys.
One, two, three, five.
Dancing. Now that's. Oh, sorry. Sorry, David. That's called the C part in music.
I got it.
So if we go, I just want to.
Take it away, buddy.
Well, let me guess. It's a C part, and it goes to E, D, A. Hit it!
2, 3, 4.
I just want.
The audience will determine. He happens to be a comedian, but he loves to sing. And he doesn't know I'm calling on him, just like you didn't know that I'm calling on you, Mark, but thanks for... not him. Wait, how old are you? How old are you? 13, do you sing?
I don't.
Do you sing? No, you just wanted to put your arms up. I get it, okay. I'm gonna go over here because I have my dear friend who's a great comedian, actor, named John Lovitz, who's here. John, are you here? There he is. Mark McGrath, can you pass the microphone to him, please? John, I'm totally ambushing you, I'm sorry to say. He's with his friend Mitch. They're not a couple. Not that that would be okay, but... Hi, John, you playing tonight at the Laugh Factory?
Yes.
Would you like to sing or something? If you don't, I'll move to something.
You might turn around. Now these people are being demanding. I'm not even about to be on stage.
You don't have to be on stage. You can just do it right from there.
No, I'm in the middle of the show now. I can't turn around. Sorry.
No, you can just sing from there. Hi, Linda. You're sitting besides my friends Peter and Linda, by the way. Hi, say hello.
Oh, nice to meet you.
He doesn't mean that. All right, John, do you want to sing a little Fly Me to the Moon, maybe, or something like that?
Yeah, but I...
Yeah, or not? I put you on the spot. I'm sorry, I'll buddy. All right. Or would you like to do some opera? Would you like to do opera?
I can do both.
Would you like to do some opera?
Apparently, he doesn't want me to sing. Look at that, David. They all know who I am. Jealous?
I'm the most expensive karaoke you'll ever have, buddy.
So, do you want to... Would you like to sing some opera, or would you like to sing Fly Me to the Moon?
Fly Me to the Moon.
Okay.
I'll do fake opera real quick.
All right.
All right, that's it.
Oops, sorry. Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3, 4.
Fly me to the moon. Let me play amongst stars. Let me see what love is like doing a show in a real theater instead of where I'm at. In other words, oh. my hand. Thank you. In other words, ladies, call me. Fill my heart with song. Let me sing forevermore. If I don't get a date tonight, I'll probably be with a whore. In other words, please be true.
Well, you know what? I'm going to just do a few songs that I wrote, okay? So screw all you guys. Saying about your ex-boss, you were the musical director for Peter Cetera, my dear friend. We wrote a lot of songs together. This was our first number one hit that we wrote together. And it goes like this. Everybody sing. Everybody needs a little time away. I heard her say, from each other, hold me now. It's hard for me to say I'm sorry. I just want you to know. Same time, Peter and I were writing a lot of songs together, and I was producing Kenny Rogers, who's a wonderful guy, and he said, hey, I love those songs you're writing for Chicago. Write me one. So Peter and I got excited, and we wrote him a song. We took it over to his house the next day. It was fast. We played it for him, and he said, and I quote, boys, I don't think that's a hit. And it doesn't feel good, but Peter and I wrote a song called The Glory of Love for the movie Karate Kid 2. Yep. The movie that beat us that year was Top Gun. I hate that movie. I really do. But sadly, for them, or for me, Top Gun had Maverick, Iceman, jets, jet fuel, rock and roll, sex, drugs, Kelly McGillis, and of course,
Tom Cruise.
Our movie, The Karate Kid 2. You guys just made me laugh. Our movie starred the guy from Happy Days. Pat Morita. The song that beat us was not Danger Zone, it was what? Take My Breath Away. I know. It's not bad. It's just rubbing it in, isn't he? We're here next month. Where are you going to be? Anyway, let's analyze that song. She goes, take my breath away. So far, so good. Then she goes, uh-huh-huh. Then she goes, uh-huh-huh. Then she goes, uh-huh-huh. She didn't even finish the fucking lyrics. I think if our song, The Glory of Love, had have been in Top Gun, I think we would have won the Oscar. I'm sure what I'm talking about.
Uh-oh.
And... We all know that, your inspiration was?
Celine Dion.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, tell me about that a little bit.
Well, basically, you and Celine taught me how to sing. Because I would just listen to Celine over and over again, and I'd practice and practice until I, could sing those songs. Took a long time.
They're tough, and they're tough. Sure, well, there was this one song, and we were in the studio, and then there's this extremely high, I put this high note in this song, I really wanted to wow the crowd, and because I like those moments in songs. And she got it right the first time. I made her sing it 7 more times, and she got crazy on me. I mean, not crazy on me, she just got upset. If you read her book, page 37, page 38, she devotes 2 pages to what a dick I was. But,
did she call you that?
No, in French.
Oh.
The dick feeling.
It's prettier than that.
We made up, of course, but then you found this thing.
Yeah, I scroll on TikTok every night before I go to sleep, and I found this clip of Celine on the Andy Cohen, The Bravo Show. And she was telling the story about when you did the song and you did the note and
right.
all that stuff.
She explains it much better than I could, but I love putting the high note in. I think the high note made the song a big hit, okay?
Amazing.
But here she explains it.
David Foster calls me, and I was in Montreal, he was in California, in Malibu. I arrived to the studio. He says, you're gonna freak. It's so amazing. But he said, I have a little surprise for you. And I'm like, oh, okay. And he plays me the track, When I Was Young. And it starts, and it's so divine. It's so beautiful. And then he said, wait at the bridge. I did a little something. And then the key that we have agreed on, he changed it to a key and a half for the modulation. And I was like, is that the final, the key that finishes is the key that we chose, right? No, he says it's a key and a half higher.
Oh my God.
But I said, David, how could you do that?
Right.
Well, he said, if you can't do it, there's other singers next to the king. And that's all I needed to hit the note.
True story. I'm sorry to say. You'll recognize the high note.
When I was young, and if I needed warmth, and making love was just for fun, those days are gone. Living low, I think of all. Not time to fall.
I did the music with the Bodyguard, Whitney Houston, and I lost.
I don't know how that's possible.
I don't know how it's possible. Where's any Whitney Houston fans out there? We'll just do a couple of abbreviated versions of those songs. I want to shout this out to my friends from Japan, yes. Hiro and Yukio, Yuki Kanasawa, who are here from all the way from Japan. They came all the way from Japan just to see little old me.
Oh my God.
I love it. Eh? Hiro and Yukio. So this is for you guys. 4, 5, 6.
Thank you.
already known you. We're not quite finished yet. The show's almost over, but we're not quite finished.
Okay.
So Kat, as many of you know, she was on a show called Scorpion for 4 years on CBS. Then she did a show called Smash for a couple of years, which was incredible. She starred on Broadway in Waitress, which was amazing. And then she did a show for Netflix called...
I did a show called Country Comfort. I played a character named Bailey Hart, and it only lasted one season, but that's okay. Since we're on the theme of losing here.
Right.
You know?
Oscars. You came in second on American Idol.
That's right.
You lost.
Oh, I did a really fun... Look, I'm just like talking like that, which is great for the character. Did y'all like to hear a country song just for fun? All right, well, we'll just throw it in. How about that?
Let's just do it. Here we go.
Okay. Where's my ladies at?
Keep up with me.
Gotta be.
So, No, you're not leaving. Okay. No, the show's almost over, but I wanted to get to the trifecta of losses.
Right.
The hat trick. Do you know what a hat trick is?
Yes.
No, you don't. What is it?
Well, I know now. It's like a baseball thing, but I still think I'm like...
It's a hockey thing.
Oh, shoot.
Yeah. Anyway, the trifecta of Oscar losses. Mm-hmm. Loss for the Bodyguard, loss for the Glory of Love, loss for this next song, which I'd love to do, and this is a kind of a nice, well, this is the song, I mean, this world could use a little bit of more songs like this. I wrote a song for Andrea Bocelli and Celine Dion with my friend Carol Bearsager, a song called The Prayer. And the interesting thing about this song is it gets played at weddings and funerals. Which,
that's okay.
For some people, is the same day, but that's some of the jokes about it. The fact is, I lost the Oscar. But,
we're
going to
do it for you right now. Nice.
Oh,
So before we leave, and there's no parking, right? You don't have cars here. It's like you just walk into the casino and lose money. Daniel has many, many sides to him, and I just love the way he sings, but he has another level that he can go to. And without even commenting further, we will just show you with the music rather than the words. David Page. It's called Got to Be Real. It goes a little bit like this. Stay on your feet, goddammit.